As humans plan to return to and establish a sustainable presence on the Moon by 2028, communication with each other on the Moon and with Earth will be very important. It is time for the Moon to get online. So NASA and ESA are embarking on an ambitious plan to build internet and GPS systems for the Moon. The establishment of these systems will enable us to open up the North and South Poles, as well as the far side of the Moon, for exploration. These systems will help set the groundwork for human habitation on the Moon and prepare us for connecting to human presence on Mars. Revolutionary as it sounds, GPS is, for now, a solution limited to our own planet. Soon, however, as humans return to the Moon, a lot of people and hardware will be heading for the Moon, so navigation and communication solutions are absolutely essential. In the Apollo era, communication with Earth was only available from the near side of the Moon and was primarily used for transmitting telemetry data and low-resolution voice and video. Current communication with the Moon is still on a direct line of sight to the Earth. That presents a problem if we ever want to explore the far side of the Moon, which never faces the Earth. Even on the side that faces us, craters and valleys can block direct line of sight to the Earth. That is why we need to develop a communication infrastructure on the Moon to provide a method of direct communication between people, equipment, and the Earth that does not require direct line of sight. ESA's Moonlight and NASA's LunaNet programs will make it easier for lunar devices, rovers, people, sensors, and exploration projects to communicate with each other and with the Earth. Envisioned much like the Internet on Earth, LunaNet would enable communications not only among humans and equipment on the Moon, but also allow each of them to transmit data back to Earth through moon-orbiting relays, such as satellites or a moon-orbiting space station like Gateway. The Gateway orbiting space station around the Moon is a multi-nation collaboration. The plan is to deploy a whole interconnected network of lunar science and exploration orbiters around the Moon, as well as surface mobile and stationary systems. Moon and Earth orbiters are being planned that will relay GPS service to lunar vehicles traveling up to Gateway, as well as those traveling from Gateway to the surface of the Moon. Once relays are in place, we will have the ability to give network connection to the lunar poles and the far side of the Moon. GPS-like technologies will be crucial for human navigation and unmanned systems on the Moon. Just like when mobile networks started on Earth, you could get phone coverage when you were in the city, but out in the country you didn't have coverage anymore. The need was to have base stations in the outlying areas. There is an armada of missions going to the Moon this decade. That is why, initially, the LunaNet community includes government, commercial, and academic entities. Eventually, it will include individuals as well. In October 2020, Nokia was awarded a contract to deploy a 4G network on the Moon by the end of 2022, and possibly, longer term, 5G would follow, which could serve as the stepping stone to the wider LunaNet. The idea is to put equipment on a lunar lander, which will function as the base station, housing the network side of the solution. The lander then deploys a rover. A cellular link is then established between this rover and the equipment on the lander. TESS will explore communication from the rover at 2 to 3 kilometers away from the lander. One challenge is to develop the equipment that can withstand the shock, vibration, and acceleration of the trip to the Moon. In addition, there are temperature changes, vacuum, and radiation to handle, too. So if you are an astronaut cruising around on the surface of the Moon, you get your network service through the equivalent of your cell phone through the Nokia cell tower. If you are trying to get data back to Earth or back around to the far side of the Moon, your data will go from that base station and work itself back to Earth through a relay or any combination of relays, the same way that the internet traffic on Earth bounces around. Some lunar communications will likely be carried out with standard TCP/IP communication protocols, but for the trip to Earth, that simply won't suffice. Earth infrastructure is primarily designed to be static. Data centers, submerged cables, and cell towers all stay put. But LunaNet has to be designed for space. Satellites can move in and out of view within minutes, requiring rapid connect and disconnect of links as they go in and out of range. Then there is a potential of radio signal interference and other issues that can cause data loss. That's why LunaNet will rely on the disruption-tolerant networking bundle protocol instead, which is a method of storing data when the relay satellite goes out of range, and then forwarding with automatic retransmission to the next relay satellite, ensuring data makes it to its destination. With a huge scientific benefit in moon operations, and with the recent discovery of significant quantities of water on the moon, methods of extracting it are already being developed. This will be critical for the future colonization of the moon. If you went to the moon on vacation 30 years from now, certainly exchanging emails and posting stuff on the web would be okay. A phone call would be possible, but it would be difficult and annoying because of the few seconds of delay. This opens up a new era of investigation into interplanetary internet. On Mars, for example, delays are measured in minutes, but there would be plenty of buffering time for data. Farther out in the solar system presents even greater problems. Even the speed of light becomes slow and time-consuming considering the vast distances. Connecting the far side of the moon will help us explore space well beyond our solar system, however, because the far side of the moon is a very quiet place. All of the racket coming from Earth is blocked by the whole moon. Buried laser communication systems have been tested successfully, demonstrating that the ability to send 622 megabits per second from the moon by laser works. So communication with the Earth will most likely be via laser transmission. The spacecraft LADEE, with its perfectly functioning laser system, was deliberately crashed into the moon in 2013 to stir up some dust to see what happens. It is now a buried communication system. Who knows? Maybe like in the movie, a stranded astronaut may dig it up someday and try to get the laser to work again. LunaNet is expected to include different categories of service. First, networking services like internet on Earth, capable of moving data between nodes. Second, GPS-like services that could be used for search and rescue or surface navigation guiding spacecraft traveling to and from the Gateway Moon Orbiting Space Station. Third, science services. Astronauts on the lunar surface will be able to receive real-time alerts generated from space weather instruments of incoming solar flares, giving them ample time to seek cover. LunaNet will be critical for communication during deliveries of science payloads to the far side and polar regions of the moon, where direct communication with Earth ground stations will be impossible without a method of relaying that communication to Earth. Reliable, resilient, and high-capacity communication networks will be key to supporting sustainable human presence on the moon's surface. With the LunaNet architecture in place, robotic landers, rovers, and astronauts on the moon will have network access similar to networks on Earth. Rovers analyzing samples can send their data directly to relays orbiting the moon, which can then transmit that data back to Earth. The European Space Agency's Moonlight Telecoms and Positioning Network will involve a plethora of satellites orbiting the moon, playing a key part in efforts to colonize the moon and beyond. Soon, from colonies on the moon, we will see HD video transmission, cell phone communication, GPS navigation, data transmission, and live video streaming from the moon.